Welcome. My name is Andrew Smith, and I am the Senior Director and Writer at lovetarantulas.com, which many of you will know is the only film production company in existence dedicated to one thing, the making of intelligent, feature-length tarantula documentaries on location. We often take you to original type sites where these spiders were first found 150 odd years ago, and then on a voyage of discovery as we explore the habitat, the biology, and the history of some of the world's most iconic tarantula spiders. And as many of you are aware, we have a long track record dating back decades. Our first documentary, Desert Tarantulas, which I have here, this is an old VHS video, was made over 35 years ago, when we were known in those days as Fitzgerald Publishing. And now, rebooted as lovetarantulas.com, we have made 8 feature-length tarantula documentaries over the last 6 years, including this one, our very first, under our new production name, Laziadora 1640, which we filmed in the dry forests along the Atlantic coast of Brazil, and features 3 of the region's big bird-eating tarantula spiders of the genus Laziadora, plus a host of cute arboreals, including Iridopelma and Pachystopelma, that we found along the way. And that footage of both the big Laziadoras and the arboreals is the very first footage ever filmed of those spiders. Next came Brachypelma, the red-legged tarantulas of Mexico. 2 documentaries filmed piggyback on the original type location sites north and south of the Rio Balsas River, where we had the privilege of filming some of the world's most beautiful tarantula spiders, including my own species, Baumgartneri. As an aside, filming those spiders was particularly hairy, in more sense than one, as we were filming along the Sierra Madre Mountains, along the Pacific coast of Mexico, a region dominated by some of Mexico's most violent drug cartels. Now, if Africa is your cup of tea, then we take you to East Africa to meet East Africa's big bad girl, Penela Bias. And this is an epic documentary, 3 hours long. I jest you not, and we take you out there into Africa, not just Penela Bias, the big girl herself. We also have a number of other East African tarantula species. Think Pteranochelys murinus. But guys, it's not just those spiders. We tell you the story about the collectors, men like Richard Crawshay, who collected Penela Bias as they were punching a railway line through East Africa. And as our collectors were trying to find the spiders, man-eating lions, Savo, were trying to eat our collectors. It is an epic story. Now, 2 years ago, we were filming in India, post-Lafaria, India's tiger spiders, and again we filmed 2 documentaries, feature length, piggyback. Now, the first documentary is all about HRP Carter's railway spiders, and we tell the story about how a small group of railway engineers collected the key post-Lafaria spiders for the famous Reginald Pocock scientific paper. Now guys, we're going to be showing you in the field Metallica. We're going to be showing you Formosa, and it is indeed scrumptious footage as we scour the eastern ghats for those spiders. But we also have a second documentary, which is considerably more tragic. 20 years ago, me and Paul Carpenter found a brand new post-Lafaria spider down deep down south, Post-Lafaria Hanuma villosumica. And we are about to tell you the tragic story, how it's highly likely that will be the first post-Lafaria spider to become extinct. And if you are listening to this Kickstarter appeal for funding for our next film project, pound to a penny, you have seen our latest epic Theraphosa and Ephobopus documentaries, South America's giant forest floor spiders. And I suspect that you've also sussed that our Theraphosa location footage is in a class of its own, filmed on location and not in dioramas. And in the Ephobopus documentary, you were watching the very first location footage again ever filmed of the striking skeleton tarantula Ephobopus murinus, plus a host of other species. that we came across while filming in the rainforest of Suriname, including the very first footage again ever filmed of Aphonopelma rufescens mating in the field. Not in a diorama, but actually caught on location mating in the field. But more than that, you have shared with us the discovery of not only the world's largest spider, but also a new Goliath spider species, the giant woolly-haired Goliath. I mean, who else other than lovetarantulas.com would take you from the rainforest of Suriname and then into the laboratories of Europe's oldest museum collections, London and Paris, and then into Europe's newest collection, the Naturalis in the Netherlands, in order to prove to you that we do indeed have a brand new Goliath species. And now we are back with a brand new tarantula documentary film project, and one which I think will give even Postlefaria and Theraphosa a run for their money. And what is the name of this brand new project? It is The Tarantula Spiders of Costa Rica. And with this new tarantula documentary, we are going to be doing something completely and utterly different from the usual one-genus projects that we've done to date. Well, of course, not that different. We're still going to begin in the museum with the type material. But this time round, we're going to be looking at a number of Costa Rica's most beautiful, iconic tarantula spider species, and then going into the field and telling you the bigger story behind each one of those spiders. And once again, we have got some of the most brilliant field footage of a host of new tarantula spiders, most of whom have never been filmed on location in the field before. Check out this footage. Aphonopelma, seemanni. Abdomegaphobema, mesomelas. Tliltocatl, albopilosus. Psalmopoeus, reduncus. Davus, fasciatum. Sphaerobothria, hoffmanni. Sandinista, lanceolatum. This documentary is going to be epic. Two 2-hour-plus productions. And I can assure you, we have in the can footage that you will drool over. But to do that, we need to raise additional money, because what we do is very, very expensive. And so far we've spent about £6,000 on this project. Flights, car hire, accommodation, and filming for 1 month in Costa Rica. Now we need another £4,000 to finish off all of the linking footage, plus some additional filming on the Isle of Wight and in Oxford and London, plus editing and the cost of the DVD. We need your help. And then I can promise you an epic new tarantula documentary that will have you on the edge of your seats. Because like Brachypelma and Postlefaria and Theraphosa, our new Costa Rican documentary is just as you like it. Muddy boots out there in the field searching for tarantula spiders. Now, if you cherish what Love Tarantulas is all about, then think about becoming a patron or even a producer and support us with whatever you can afford. And in doing so, you will go onto our roll of honour in the credits. And depending on how much you donate, you will also have access to all sorts of Love Tarantulas goodies. Or if you have a business associated with the hobby, why not become an executive producer? Now, these are the people who have their company logos at the front of our documentaries. And in doing so, they are the entomological and arachnological companies who are telling the world they are proud to support groundbreaking, intelligent tarantula documentaries that increase our knowledge of these wonderful spiders. Onlylovetarantulas.com does what we do. And we can only do it with your support. Thank you.